हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम सौरभ जादव, स्टडिंग इन बीई सिविल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट गर्डा इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी लवेल। लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट आवर बीई प्रोजेक्ट। माय ग्रुप मेंबर्स आर प्रवीण राणे, तन्मय गोठनकर एंड दर्शन गायकवाड। आवर प्रोजेक्ट गाइड्स आर प्रोफेसर परोळेकर सर एंड प्रोफेसर जाधव सर। द टॉपिक ऑफ आवर प्रोजेक्ट इज कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ वॉटर स्टोरेज टैंक बिलो द ग्राउंड बाय यूजिंग फेरोसीमेंट। लेट अस नो व्हाई वी हैव सिलेक्टेड दिस टॉपिक। आवर कॉलेज इज present in a Konkan region, the place where the peoples are mostly depends upon the agriculture. The crop of rice is cultivated once in a year because it requires large amount of water. Due to single cropping, it reduces the income sources of local peoples, results in a poor economic conditions of the many families. From this, we know that our project must be economical. Also, as compared to other regions, the amount of precipitation in this region is more. Due to this, most of houses have roofs with steep slopes. Although people are facing scarcity of water from March to the May month of year due to lowering of water table during these months, we identified the problem and decided to work on them. While searching solutions to these problems, we came across a technique of ferrocement. For the collection of primary data, we had conducted a survey at Vada village in Pen. This area is located near coastal regions, hence availability of salty water is more, resulting in scarcity of drinking water. We observed that there are water ponds near each house which stores salty water during high flooding rainy season. This salty water in ponds is used for the daily household needs throughout the year. Thus, to overcome scarcity of drinking water, more than 150 ferrocement tanks were constructed in 2002 under Shivkalin Pani Purvata Yojana. The study helped us to understand construction methods of ferrocement tank, its durability, and measures required to reduce its construction cost for economical tank construction. To know more about ferrocement construction, we have attended one-day national training workshop on exploring ferrocement at Pillai HOC College of Engineering and Technology, Rasayani, on 27 September 2019. Dr. P.P. Lele, Honorable Secretary of Ferrocement Society of India, told us about the ferrocement construction. We learned to bind the meshes, method of placing mortar due to hands-on training. This workshop helped us a lot for our BE project. As there is no ICE code available for ferrocement construction, the experts from Ferrocement Society of India provided us a quality information used in actual practices which we have adopted for our project. For the construction of water storage tank, the layout of tank is marked on the site and the soil is excavated up to the required depth. The mortar cubes were casted with the variable percentage of fly ash, and the optimum, which is 10% of fly ash, is used for the tank construction. The cutting of wire mesh and casting of cover blocks was the prerequisites for the tank. The cover blocks were casted accordingly. Then 75 mm PCC were casted as a base layer with M10 grade of concrete. The wire mesh is placed over PCC by maintaining cover using cover blocks. Now the mortar is mixed with the proportion of 1:3 and 10% addition of fly ash as a replacement to cement, and it applied over the reinforcing mesh. Now the final coat of waterproofing is applied to avoid seepage of water and for surface finishing. After 28 days of curing with rice husk, the ferrocement underground tank is ready to be used. As the capacity of tank is 2691 liters and the construction cost is 6043 rupees, the tank bears cost of 2 rupees per liter, which is economical than conventional tanks. The following results were observed. The shrinkage cracks are not present due to good curing and use of admixture in tank construction. No percolation losses were observed. It is observed that the construction cost and material requirement for ferrocement tank below the ground is very less as compared to conventional masonry and plastic tank of equal capacity. From the project, it is concluded that The Ferrosement technique is effective for construction of water storage tank below the ground, and it is beneficial for drought-prone areas. The locally available materials can be utilized for the tank's construction with fly ash as a supplementary cementitious material. Thank you.